I will share some news regarding Business Central. And like Sander already mentioned, the part of Chris is more or less moved to the dedicated session to of tomorrow. But nevertheless, I will cover some news around Power Apps. First, some exciting news. Microsoft has shared that now on AppSource for Business Central SaaS, we have reached the 1500 milestone. So we now have more than 1500 apps available on AppSource. So that's good to see that there is really some growth. ISVs are converting their IP into apps available on AppSource. So over time, more and more end customers are able to migrate to Business Central SaaS because the required IP or vertical solutions they are relying on will become more and more available on AppSource. So that's a great milestone Microsoft achieved, together, of course, with all the ISVs and partners contributing to this. Then some news for the update of Business Central 18.1, so the minor update 1. It's out for a while now for Business Central SaaS, but it's still not available for on-prem yet because Microsoft delayed it earlier. And they found out that there was a bug in the installer of Business Central on-prem. And they had to fix that, basically have to write it from scratch. That's also the reason why, and we have seen that report by several partners to us, that partners were not able to install a new Business Central environment on Business Central 18. However, the release 18.1 for on-prem is expected to be released tomorrow, so May 28. So from that moment on, you should be able to install Business Central on-prem again. Then I would like to highlight a feature. Of course, it's one of the features of the April release, but it deserves some more attention, and it also highlights the way Microsoft is going by making it easier to set up things within Business Central by assisted setups, and also convert those into easy to understand wizards. One of them is the assisted setup that helps to move the task of adjusting item cost to the background. On the inventory setup page, when you turn off the automatic cost posting or specify it as a never in the automatic cost adjustment field, then automatically an assisted setup guide, a wizard, becomes available, and that can help you on each step of the way. So basically it helps you to create a job queue, for example, to adjust those on a regular base via a job queue. And of course you're also able to create that job queue from scratch in the job queue page, but it's a way easier by doing it via a wizard. And we expect that Microsoft will launch and convert more and more assisted setups into easy to understand wizards. Then scheduling minor updates, like I said before. We are now on 18.1 on Business Central SaaS, and I highlighted this feature last month or the month before. Although we were already able to schedule the major updates, so the update to Business Central 17, 18, and later to Business Central 19, the minor updates were pushed formally just by Microsoft, and you just got an email that it was done. And now you get upfront an email with a notification that you're able, that you basically have 7 days to schedule that update, when that minor update needs to take place, within 21 days. So within 3 weeks after it becomes available. Currently, it's only available in the US, but with 18.2 releasing very soon, it will become in other countries also in Western Europe as well. And Basically, we saw already some partners asking where they can find it. Of course, it's in the Business Central Admin Center. And on the picture, you see one of the environments. And then you see, just like with major updates, you see that there's an update available. You see available update version 18.1. And then you see that you're able to modify the date, which is found in the field update will start on or after. And basically, you have 7 days to modify that date and then choose a date within the first 3 weeks. So that's great news. You as a partner have back the control on when an update will be rolled out. So you can choose a date in the weekend, for example. I would also like to highlight the next Business Central Office Hours calls hosted by Microsoft. The next one is on Tuesday, June 1st. And it's all around the Business Central Performance Toolkit. And in this call, they will share some practical how-tos on how to use the toolkit. And of course, there's room for Q&A. And you can simply register via the link presented in this slide. And when the slides are shared with you, you have the direct link. It's free. So if you're interested in how to fine-tune the performance of Business Central, please have a look and register for this Business Central Office Hours call. Then we have seen, and also Microsoft has seen, of course, that they saw a huge number of bugs reportings around a bug in the report 1306, so the sales invoice. And that sales invoice is or was actually displaying wrong values for the subtotal and the tax amount field. That was a worldwide issue. The fix has been identified. And as far as I know, currently it has been rolled out to all the regions. However, there popped up one more issue. And basically, Microsoft is working on that now, and that's when the total including VAT or tax field ends in a zero decimal, so .00, the decimal places are being dropped from the layout. And it's good to know that Microsoft is working on that as well. So if your customers are raising questions around the report of the sales invoice, especially the 1306 report, please be aware that the first bugs are already fixed and rolled out in the regions for Business Central SaaS, and the last issue, known issue, will be fixed very soon, and they will fix it via a hotfix. Then something different, and maybe the majority of you already is aware of it, but we also see some partners struggling with it, and that's the use of customer permission sets, because that can be very tricky. Because we have seen a lot of people complaining about errors when they would like to log into Business Central SaaS after the update from 17.5 to Business Central 18. They get the error message as shown on this slide, that the people don't have the following permissions on table data checklist setup. And all of those partners, or all of those end customers of those partners, are working with custom permission sets. And if Microsoft adds new tables, then Microsoft, of course, includes them into standard permission sets. And for example, the checklist setup that has to do with the onboarding visits, the assisted setups checklist, which is now available in the role center in Business Central. Basically, what it does is it checks every time if a user logs in, it checks if the setup has already been completed, yes or no, and that's stored in this table. But if you're working with custom permission sets only, Microsoft has added this feature, and you don't have covered that table in one of your custom permission sets, people are, of course, getting bored with this error message the next time after the update, when they log into the environment. So it doesn't necessarily have to be a problem if you update your custom permission sets, but maybe it makes sense to think about changing your approach and at least try to see if it's possible to work with the basic, the default basic permission sets Microsoft is providing, because Microsoft will update those permission sets. So then if you update to Business Central 18, next time the users will not get bored by such types of errors regarding permission sets. Okay, the next slide, I described why this error occurred. Like I mentioned before, it has to do with the checklist and the onboarding checklist on the role center. And there's no way around it. So either, like I mentioned before, change your approach and make use of the default permission sets, or be very sure that you are updating your custom permission sets upfront to make sure that the new edit tables are covered somewhere in the permission sets. Then something different. We have already published the third QBS Group GitHub repository. This time, Mark Brummel has described some information around how to solve printing to Zebra printers and other older printers from Business Central Cloud, using and making use of the Azure Blob Storage, because these printers are often a bit older and can be quite expensive to replace, so people are still using them. But that should not be a blocking point and a blocking issue for cloud migrations. So in order to connect all the devices to Business Central, we decided to share this repository with you. So the samples, the stuff, the code, and also the README files are available on our GitHub. And good to know, this is the third one, and we have the intention to come up and share more and more stuff in our QBS Group GitHub. So make sure you're checking this on a regular basis. And of course, it will also be highlighted in newsletters or social media posts. Then application insights. Early this week, we launched a new blog called Help My Application Insight Explodes, a blog written again by Mark Brummel, because we think as QBS Group that application insights, if you as a partner are making use of it, it could be a huge time and therefore a cost saver for you as a partner. But of course, it's not free. Working on Azure is not free, but with 5 gigabytes per month, it should be sufficient in most of the cases. However, some partners reached out to us and reported unexpected high usage and therefore high unexpected bills for making for the usage of Azure. Together with Microsoft, Mark Brummel with Kenny and some other guys have investigated the issues and produced some tips and tricks for you to avoid such large bills. So please have a look at the blog. It's for your benefit. And one example, just as a giveaway, please be aware of the fact that if you are making use of Application Insights by default without, for example, making use of the tips and tricks Mark Brummel is sharing with you, if an end customer of you is downloading some new additional apps from AppSource to the Business Central environment, and they've installed it and they are making use of it, that could increase the data usage on Azure for Application Insights. And then you as the partner will get invoiced, of course. So you are the first to see the usage is has shown a significant growth, and you get the bill, and of course you have to invoice your end customer. But it's good to know that these type of things can occur and cause usage and therefore large bills for making use of application insight. But as a summary, don't worry, it doesn't have to be this way. Like I said before, with a free 5 GB per month, it should be sufficient in most of the cases to make use of application insights for your end customers. And once again, that could be a huge time and cost save of you as a partner. Then, like I said in the beginning, I would like to share some news around Power Apps, because we all think, or at least we are convinced, that Power Apps is great. And it's presented by Microsoft as the solution for everything. If something is not available in Business Central and it's some easy task on a mobile device, for example, you can simply create a Power App for that. And it's presented as a low-code platform. But although it's low-code, you still need to know how to low-code. And the ultimate low-code app building experience is that one where you describe in plain language what you want to what you want the app to do, and in an instant that app is created for you. Now you can with Power Apps, and I will explain it with a few examples, because Microsoft has added now the functionality to automatically generate PowerFX formulas based on plain natural language input. So for example, if you are creating a Power App, and for example, you're creating a screen where you would like to give the user a list only with the customers from the US, for those customers, the subscription has been expired. You simply, in Power Apps, go to that page and say in the code field, show me customers from the US whose subscription has been expired. And then Power Apps will come back to you with the suggestion how the code would look like. So let me show you how that works. It's a GIF, so I will run it twice. Here you're in Power Apps, and you're on a list page, and you want to filter that list page. You simply, in the right pane, type the plain text. And as you see under answers, Power Apps will suggest on which code to use to get that result. So once again, you type in show me customers from the US whose subscription has been expired. And then in the answers, Microsoft already has translated that for you into the code you need to use. And that's really an example of low-code experience needed to create a Power App. But there are some more examples. For example, if the plain input is show 10 orders that have stroller in the product name and sort by purchase date with newest on the top. Very plain text on the result you want to achieve. And then the AI in Power Apps will suggest the code output. So then you click on the code suggested within Power Apps, and then that code is inserted into that field. And another example, for example, you have a list with names, contact names, just a very simple example. For example, it's full first name, full last name. So for example, John Smith, and you would like to change that list into John S, so just the first letter of the last name, then you can also get AI generated code by typing in an example how you would like to have the result. So you simply type in John S, and then Power Apps will come up with this complicated code, so to say, if you're talking about low code, how to achieve that. So that's some great news around Power Apps, where it will be much easier, especially for partners with experience in Business Central, but zero to none experience in Dynamics 365 for Sales or Dataverse or Power Apps or whatever. It will be much easier for you to go the way by making use of Power Apps. So go down that road, investigate the possibilities, and see how easy it is to make use of Power Apps and code those really low code apps. And like I mentioned before, Chris is covering more info in the session tomorrow. And feel free to ask some more information about this in the session tomorrow. And that was basically it in terms of relevant Business Central news to share with you this month. If you have any questions, please let me know. And Sander, back to you to see if there are any questions raised in the chat window.